Alright, hi everybody, it's me, Bonkai922. This is super... Well, not that late, it's 3 days late. The Akame got Kiru kill episode 15 review, which I'm about to do. And after this, I'm probably going to try to do Taizai and Attack on Titan. But I won't upload them until tomorrow. But it's how I'll upload now. This episode 15... Killer religious organization. I'm noticing it now. It is becoming very clear. They're going really going real quick with the pacing here. For the anime only watchers who are probably going to be screaming, "Goddamn Bonkai, why are you doing this?" I'm not spoiling anything, but prepare yourself because big time battle. Massive. Well, what was set, and this was pretty much the best way to explain this episode. This was a setup episode. And that is the best way to explain it. It was a setup episode for what is about to become, for what is to come, which is this massive battle between the Night Raid against the Few. Jaeger members, which is not a lot. It's Bulls, and Kurumi. But as you'll see in the next episode, Kurumi's got more when it concerns her Tegu, her sword. She does a lot of shit. But pretty much this episode is a setup. You know, the Jaegers are getting ready to go to battle against the Night Raid. Night Raid's getting ready to go to battle against the Jaegers. That's pretty much the story. Now, overall rating, I would say, I think it's a 4. Because it's really just a setup episode. There's really nothing to state other than that. I liked how, you know, you had the different size of it and how they put it into the episode. You know, I thought that was done very well. I also, which was pretty much shown in the manga, but I thought it was done well here. You know, how Wave is a character in Akame that I feel bad for him. I really do. Because the fact of the matter is, this guy, in some ways, is almost identical to Tatsumi. In some ways. Because he basically, you know, he's trying to, he's a good guy, Wave. And, you know, when he sees shit like Siryu, cute justice. And he's like, he could tell. He's like, it's fucked up what they're doing. The way they do about it, go about it. And he's like, he basically stating to himself, all I can do now is just be a soldier and do the orders that are given to me, you know. And, you know, it's interesting to see Wave's character in that light. You know, you realize he's not a bad guy. It's just, he's thrown into bad situations and stuff, so he's a good guy, you know. But, you know, that was interesting to see of that. And this is, like, pretty much, like I said, setup chapter. So I'm only giving it a 4 out of 5. And I noticed that the pacing's going really quickly here. But next episode and the next couple coming up, just good heads up for you guys. Heads up. I hope you've got your seatbelts strapped in. This is one hell of a fucking trip. This coming battle. It's I'm not spoiling. I'm just letting you guys know. It's fucking ridiculous. What goes down. Moving forward. And you know, that was pretty much it. There's really not much to this episode. It was just really set up. Also, we found out about the religious organization. Path of Peace. They're an interesting group, their leader, is an interesting person. You find out details later on about that. But overall, like I said, 4 out of 5, Melts the State. I mean, you did see Kurumi. She can bring back the dead, pretty much. And what she does in the next episode is really crazy. It's really fucking crazy. Like, you already saw in the episode, she brought a danger beast that was dead. It's like a skeleton. Like, come on. She's fucking ridiculous. But, you know, it's a massive battle, but, like, even though it's only two members of of the Jaegers that are fighting them, you know, it gets pretty crazy, even though it's only two, because of the fact that Kurumi, she's bringing back things from the dead. And these things are fighting for her, pretty much. And that's what the whole premise of the next episode is called, Kill the Puppets. But, yeah. Like I said, 4 out of 5, pretty awesome episode. That was a setup episode. That was pretty much what it was. And this battle is going to be crazy. This battle goes into several things. This battle goes into a kind of another battle that transpires as you go along. Not going to say DEATH flags, but you should be prepared. You should be prepared. But that's all I got for you guys. Nothing else to say. Hopefully, don't hate me. Don't hate me. But yeah, that's pretty much the story. Bankai 922. See you guys later. Like I said, Attack on Titan review is coming up. I will upload it tomorrow along with Taizai. Maggie came out. Maggie was a very interesting chapter. It was very more like you begin to see now a similarity with Hakureyu and Judar to Arba. But that's pretty much the story there. Bankai 922. See you guys later. I didn't want to mention this because people would say, you know what? I'm gonna say it. I'm gonna get a new computer, unfortunately, because I don't want to fuck around here and just, because I'm using my iPad right now, and frankly, I don't want to have to bullshit with this computer anymore. I'm gonna get a new one. I'm gonna still keep this one, but I'm just gonna get a new one. PC. I'm thinking touchscreen. But alright, Bankai 922, I will see you guys later. This battle will be fucking ridiculous when you guys see it next week. It is ridiculous. See you guys later. Peace.